Everybody, welcome to Managerial Accounting Process Costing. We're going to start up here with FIFO, or first in, first out, for equivalent units. So let's remember here what we've looked at: weighted average, and now we're looking at FIFO. What does FIFO mean? It means first in, first out. So what we're really doing here, and this is the biggest important part, is when I have these beginning direct materials costs, my beginning conversion costs, the first thing I'm going to do is get them out and send them immediately to finished goods inventory. And so what we're really going to be focused on is what our costs were during the month. Okay, so here's our sample question. We manufacture breakfast cereal and we use process accounting to transfer costs between departments. On November 1st, 2023, we had 20,000 units in beginning inventory that were 80% complete with respect to materials and 30% complete with respect to conversion. These percentages, unlike weighted average, become extremely important for FIFO. In addition to the beginning inventory, I started and completed 300,000 units. My ending inventory consisted of 40,000 units that were 25% complete with respect to materials and 20% complete with respect to conversion. So using FIFO, process costing, determine the equivalent units of direct materials and conversion for the month of November. So let's get to it. So right over here, let's just remind ourselves of what we're doing. Our beginning inventory for work in process direct material, it is the same numbers I was using for the other question. So this is 110,500. And then over here, my beginning inventory over here, this is going to be 107,400. My cost during the month for direct materials were 549,500. My conversion beginning inventory is 107.4, and my conversion during the month is going to be over here of 483,000. Okay. Now, because we're doing FIFO, this is the first thing I want you to do when you get these types of questions. The first thing I want you to go through and do is get rid of that beginning inventory and send it immediately to finished goods. So over here, we're going to take 110,500 and put it directly to finished goods. So over here, 110,500. This is going to be my beginning direct materials costs from WIP. Over here, I'm going to come over here and look at, I'm going to take 107,400 and send this immediately to finished goods. So again, first in, first out. I'm taking whatever is in my beginning inventory and immediately sending this over to my finished goods. Now, once I go through and do this, right, we haven't even gotten to equivalent units yet, but you have to see the pictorial, right? It's very important. Once I send this stuff out, right, what am I left with? I'm going to be left with my cost during the month. Or over here, it's 483,000. Over here, it's going to be 549,500. So now at this point in time, what I'm going to be focused on after I go through and move this out to finished goods is how much now through the process of equivalent units, how much now am I going over here and taking and putting into finished goods, right? So this is the whole point in terms of what we're going through and dealing with in terms of our equivalent units. So now that we know kind of what we're tasked with doing, let's figure out equivalent units under FIFO. Okay, so in the last video I went through and made, okay, what we have over here is we have our beginning inventory units. We had 20,000 units. I had 20,000 units in beginning inventory. My started and completed was 300,000 units. My ending inventory was 40,000 units. But when we go through and are doing equivalent units, right, what do I have to make sure that I'm doing? Well, if it's 40,000 that are only 25% complete with respect to conversion, that's not the same as the $300,000 that we converted during the period. So what I want to do is I'm going to go ahead and do the same calculation that I did for weighted average. So this is going to be FIFO equivalent units for direct materials. So over here, this is going to be 40,000 times 25%. Okay. So over here, it tells me my ending inventory were 25% with respect to materials. Okay, so this is the exact same as weighted average. The started and completed is also the exact same as weighted average. Okay, now our biggest difference here is on the beginning inventory equivalent units. And why? Because I already shipped out these costs, what I need to do is I need to disregard, right? I'm not going to say that these were 100% complete. Why? Because I took out these finished goods. The first thing I did is FIFO, first in, first out. I sent these beginning inventory costs immediately to finished goods. So when I'm going through and looking at equivalent units under FIFO, for my beginning inventory costs, these were 80% complete with respect to materials, but they weren't 100% complete. How much more did I need to do? Well, this is going to be 20,000 units times 20%, or 100% minus 80% already complete, or 0.2, right? What did I need to do to make these 20,000 units 100% complete? It's going to be another 20%. So I'm going to take 20,000 times 0.2. Again, this is FIFO. I shipped out these costs under weighted average. We said it was 100%, but now I'm focusing on what did I need to do during the period to make those units 100% complete. And over here, if they were already 80% complete, I just need another 20% to make them 100% complete. Let's do the same thing over here. For FIFO, for equivalent units for conversion. So my ending inventory, the same is going to be exactly the same as weighted average. They were 20% complete with respect to conversion. So this is going to be 40,000 times 0.2 or 8,000 equivalent units. Excuse me. Okay, so right over here, this is going to be 40,000 times 20% complete. My started and completed. I completed these all during the period. This is going to be times 100% complete. So this is just going to be another 300,000. Now over here for the beginning inventory for this, it says that the 20,000 units were 30% complete. So what did I need to do to make them 100% complete? Well, if they were already 30% complete, to make them 100%, I need another 70%. So over here, this is going to be 20,000 times 70%, or 100% minus 30%. And let's just do this over here. This is 20%. Okay, so again, big difference between the two methodologies. It all has to do with beginning inventory in terms of equivalent units and also the beginning inventory costs, right? Think about it. The first thing I went through and do is I shipped out these costs to finished goods. Therefore, with my beginning inventory costs, I'm focused on what I did during the period. So over here, so my equivalent units for direct materials under FIFO, it's going to be 4,000 plus 300 plus 10 or 314. My equivalent units under conversion or direct materials, or excuse me, direct labor plus factory overhead under conversion for FIFO is going to be 322,000. So this is how I go through and compute equivalent units. I realize that this video is a little bit longer, but this is by far one of the most challenging concepts for students. As you're starting to learn process costing is what happens over here with FIFO. But trust me, if you do the first in, first out, you ship out these beginning parts, then what we're focused on is what do we need to do to make these beginning inventory units 100% complete? under a weighted average, right? The started and completed and ending inventory are going to be exactly the same. The only difference is how we go through and handle our beginning inventory. So I want to thank you for being here today. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them below, and greatly appreciate you liking and subscribing to the channel. Have a great day.